Hi guys, my name's Cash and I want to do a video discussing some of the do's and the don'ts about having a dog here in China. Now, I've been here for about 1 year. I teach at a private school here in Hangzhou in China. And this video really has come from the fact that I now have a dog and some of the things that I've experienced here this year. And also some of the experiences of my friends who have adopted both cats and dogs. Now, Hangzhou is quite a large city. There's 8 to 9 million people here. It's just slightly smaller than London, but it's counted as a second tier city. It's not like Shanghai or Beijing, but they all have certain restrictions on having a dog. Now, Hangzhou this year has been very, very strict on what you need to do and what you shouldn't do if you have a dog. However, cities like Shanghai and Beijing have much stricter rules on what you can and can't do with your dogs. So it's always worth going on the internet and finding out exactly what you need if you're going to bring your dog here to China or if you envision that you're going to adopt or buy a dog here. Now, when I first came here, I had no intentions of having a pet whatsoever. But after 2 months of working here, one of my friends told me about a street puppy who had been left on the side of the road. Now, I ended up adopting her and rescuing her from the street, and she's now 1 year old, so I've had her for a little bit of time. I'm just gonna quickly introduce you to Scout, and I'm gonna insert a video here. Dum 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 dum. Now, many of the restrictions and the laws that have been put in place here in China have been due to a number of instances in the past few years. This involves aggressive, untrained dogs and irresponsible owners. So last year in December 2018, Hangzhou had a massive problem with dogs. In fact, you may have seen in the media, wherever you are, about Hangzhou being described as hell for dogs. Now, this came about after a woman was trying to protect her child who was scared of a dog, and the owner of that dog actually beat up the woman. And so the local government decided that they were going to do something about the pet dogs in the city. But instead of actually restricting the owners and fining the owners for their irresponsible behaviour, they actually decided to do it to the dogs. Now, there are some laws that have now been put in place in the city centre, and they have kind of spread out across the city. Now in July 2019, they're not seen as being as strict as they were, and between December 2018 and January 2019, they were very strictly enforced. So what are these rules and what should you do and what should you not do when you have a dog in China? Number one, when you're walking your dog, I would advise that you always have them on the lead, whether they are off-lead trained or not. Now, a lot of Chinese people here have a very different understanding of dogs. I've come from England. We know dogs to be man's best friend. However, in China, while there are those that love dogs, there are those that absolutely hate them. And I've been walking Scout quite a bit here on the compound, outside the compound. And what I found is many children absolutely adore her, want to play with her. They always point her out, they stand and watch. But it seems as they get older, become teenagers and adults, this kind of mentality changes. I don't know whether it's they believe all dogs have rabies or aggressive, but I have actually walked Scout around the compound and I've had adults run past her because they are petrified. I've had people not get in the lift because they've seen the dog. I have seen all sorts. I've seen people take pictures, which I've been very, very wary about. And people just giving like very uncomfortable looks about having a dog. Sometimes I feel like I'm walking a lion. That's the sort of look or sort of mentality that people have here. Now, the second thing that you need to make sure is that if you are a responsible owner, you should be doing this anyway, but you pick up after your dog when they have gone to the toilet. And that has been a real focus on local Chinese people. They hate it when dogs poo in the compounds or in local areas and people don't pick it up. So there can be a very, very hefty fine if you are caught allowing your dog to use the toilet without picking up after. So number three. A really big issue that we've had here is registering dogs. Now, unlike a lot of countries here, you have to fill in a lot of paperwork, go to the animal inspection unit and have your dog signed off. And you get a special little passport and that says that you are the registered owner of that dog. And that is so if there are any problems, whether it be aggressive behaviour or your dog goes missing, then they can track you down. Not having your dog registered, regardless of how long you've had it, just means that that dog is treated like it's a stray. And so that dog can be taken away from you, whether you're walking it or if they come to your apartment, that dog can go. That happened in December. And actually, in that period in Hangzhou, there were so many people going to register their dogs that vets were turning away all other animals in order to make sure that they registered everyone. Now, there is a problem with registration, because actually, the government in Hangzhou have decided that 39 dog breeds are banned from the city altogether. Now, these breeds can be too large, too aggressive in the eyes of the Chinese government. And I'm actually going to put a list down here near the comment section of all the dogs that are banned in Hangzhou right now. And Hangzhou is not the only city that's banned certain breeds. Shanghai, Beijing, Chengdu, Xi'an, they've all banned certain types of dogs. Scout is actually not registered, and that's been a real big problem for me, because I want to make sure that she is safe and I want to make sure that she's not taken away. But because I couldn't prove what breeds her parents were, they did not allow me to register her. As they said, she was not in the registration list of dogs that they would allow in the city. So as she is a mixed breed, we have a bit of a problem. So what happens if you do not register your dog? So one of two things can happen. First of all, we have a group of people in the city called Chengguan. They are like animal inspectors. They sometimes walk around, patrol, and they may come up to you and ask you for your dog's passport. If you do not have one, they legally can take your dog away. Secondly, if your neighbor complains because your dog is making too much noise or is aggressive or makes trouble, you may get a knock at the door. And that is because they come to take the dog away. So it's very, very important that if you bring a dog from England here, you still actually get them registered. And if you decide to adopt or rescue here, that you do the exact same thing. Okay, so the next point of what you have to do with a dog. Step four, make sure that if you rescue or save any dogs here, you take them for a full vet check. Now, luckily, Scout was only 2 months when I had her. And when I took her for a vet check, she was completely healthy. There was nothing wrong with her. We had the vaccinations done. But there are a lot of dogs in China that still have rabies, distemper, and parvovirus. And having one of those is a major problem for a lot of dogs. And it can be fatal in a lot of situations. In fact, rabies, as you are aware, is untreatable at the moment. You can only prevent it or try to prevent it. And so that is something you definitely need to do. Number five, if you're coming to Hangzhou, I really suggest you do not live in the city centre. And by the city centre, I mean the Westlake area, particularly if you have a dog. Now, some of the laws there are very strict. It's known as the extra restrictive zone. Anyone caught with large dogs or very aggressive dogs, that dog will be taken immediately. In fact, now you cannot walk your dogs between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. if you live in this area. Now, I live in another district called Zhaoshan, which is kind of like a suburb of Hangzhou, and we don't really get many Chengguan around here, so I've been absolutely fine walking Scout on the compound. But the closer you get into the city, the more problems that can come about. Now, these breeds that are banned from Hangzhou, people will report them if they see them. In fact, you will find that there's probably 3 or 4 really popular breeds here. You have your Bichon Frise, your poodles, and your corgis. I've rarely seen a large dog. Now, I've been here a year and I've seen one Labrador and that's it. So that is something to bear in mind. Now, they're the main things I really wanted to cover in this video. Because when I got my dog, I knew that it was very difficult finding information. And it's very difficult when you don't speak the language and you can't read Chinese and know what you need to do. So it took me a very long time trying to find out how I can keep my dog safe as best as possible. And while I've tried the registration avenue, it's been something that I'm not able to do. So I just have to be very careful. Now, in this video, I've not covered quite a few things, like the registration process, taking dogs in and out of China, what it's like having a rescue dog. I've had many challenges with her. As you know, some dogs can suffer from things like separation anxiety and trauma from their previous events. But these are all things that I'd like to cover in future videos. And Scout is not actually my only pet here in China. So I am looking to do more videos about how to look after pets while out here. So if you're interested in knowing anything about pets in China, hit me up in the comments and I'll try and find as much information as I can. It could be to do with other cities or what to do for registration, and I will try and do a video on it. Thank you.